to use your knit radar on your Singer Studio Silver Reed machines. Some of them are built into the machines, some of them are not. Now I have myself an older model here, the KR6, that will work on all my studio machines. I do have the Singer 155 that it'll go on. This is my mid-gauge Studio 860 it'll go on. And I also have a Studio 840 standard bed that will go on. And as long as I do up my swatch, and actually you do have to make up a swatch, you have to measure your gauge first before you use this accessory. Different machines you cast on different amount of stitches. For the standard gauge, I believe it said to cast on 70 stitches, and then you're going to knit 30 rows, put your markers, knit another 30 rows, contrast and color yarn, and then your last main yarn. For the bulky, you're going to do half of that. Now on the standard bed machines, you could do every other needle and make that into a bulky. So you would do the same. You would bring out every other needle from 35 right to 35 left. One of them is going to be on 34, of course. You may want to just add that one extra needle off to the side on 36. And but being every other needle, that now is going to be the bulky machine. So now on the SK-155 and any other model, studio, Singer machine that can take a knit radar, you just pretty much go to 15 and 15. I think it was, about 15 and 15 should be good enough. You can go 20 and 20 on both sides just to be on the safe side. So you're doing 40 stitches on the bulky. Now, being the mid-gauge, I am doing from left 25 to right 25, so I have 50 needles in work. I did up 10 rows of my main yarn. You probably want to make up a swatch. Get the tension dial set in that you want, that you like how the fabric comes out first. It'd be best to use the same kind of yarn. If you had a different color yarn, you could do that. Then you're going to knit 2 rows of the contrast in color. So now I am going to knit I'll knit 25 rows on this. Place a marker. Now on the standard bed machine, you're going to take left 21 and right 21 needle out so that you could place a little length of yarn. Now I'm going to take needle 15 because I want to have, and I'm doing on the right so that when I measure on the knit side, it's actually on the left. As you see, I pulled the needle out, put the length on the hook, and then hand knitted that back. If you're using every other needle on the standard, again, you're going to be doing the 21, 22, whatever it happens to be. On the bulky, you're going to do left and right 11. So now you're going to knit the same amount of rows that you did before. So I'm going to knit another 25 rows. And normally, you're going to knit another 2 rows of the contrast in color. So you can measure in between with the ruler that are for those machines. I don't happen to have the set rulers and scale rulers for the mid-gauge, so I'm going to be using either the bulky, probably more like the standard gauge ruler, scale rulers, because I do have my tension dial set to 2 2/3. Now, if I had it on the higher end of the tension dial, I'd probably be using the bulky scale rulers. So, depending on how many stitches you get for 10 centimeters or 4 inches is going to reflect on what ruler you're using. I may not be able to make an adult sweater using this, but I certainly can make a child sweater. So let me go ahead, finish this off, and then I'm going to take it off the machine. Another note is if you're working with cotton or wool yarn or any other natural fiber that will shrink when it's washed, you're going to want to bind off. You're going to take your little contrasting colors here that marks the stitches, and you're going to have to tie it off somehow. Take one strand, go through the loop to the right of it, and then tie a knot. This is just a little sample anyways. You may want to measure it before washing and drying, but you definitely have to measure it after washing and drying so that you could set your knit radar to work properly to make the garment that you want to make. Also, if you're doing a tuck stitch, now this is the electronic machine and I don't have my EC1 hooked up to this or design a knit with on the laptop. To get my tuck stitch or a slip stitch or even fair isle. So I will just be doing plain stockinette. If you are going to be doing a tuck stitch on your garment, right after you do your first two rows of contrasting color, set your machine to do that particular stitch. Whether it's a punch card manual machine or you got an electronic one, you do need to measure up what design you're using. Okay, so the standard gauge and bulky gauge has their metric ruler so that when you take the edge of it and you have the other contrasting color over here, you can tell right away how many stitches per inch you have. Now, neither one of these is going to work for me. So what I have to do is I have to take my metric ruler and I line up that line there just to the right of my marker there. Then I carefully, starting from 10, count how many stitches I have in that amount. Now I have 23. So I make a little note, what machine, what tension dial, what yarn. Now I have 23 stitches. Now to measure the rows, I'm going to do the same thing.